My name is Susan Gates. I am the National Director of America's Edge, which is a nonprofit organization of over 400 business leaders from across the United States, including over 50 here in the state of Washington. Our members work to strengthen businesses and the economy through proven investments in children and youth. And we're here today to call on Washington's state legislators and the Washington congressional delegation to counter a widening skills gap that is hampering American businesses, including businesses here in the state of Washington, by prioritizing and protecting funding for high-quality early learning programs.
Our state is facing a growing skills gap crisis. Thousands and thousands of jobs in our state are going unfilled right now because we do not have the workers with the skills necessary to fill these jobs.
America's workforce will have to outperform the foreign competition in order to ensure our viability in the marketplace. But if our economy is advancing along with technology, then too must our education system keep up with pace as well.
There's no easy tune-up to put our economic recovery into overdrive, and there's no quick fix to fill the widening skills gap. But to ensure businesses have qualified workers equipped to compete in global economy, we need an education system that will equip students with the skills for a successful career. Rigorous research shows that early learning programs can help children develop the foundations for both the hard and increasingly important soft skills, communication, collaboration, and critical thinking. For my refinery, we need operators who have very good attention to detail to be able to manage our complex refining processes. Today's environment of texting and sound bites don't adequately prepare people to learn and retain the large amount of knowledge needed to be successful operators. That attention to detail focus needs to be learned early in a person's life.
You know, early learning, everybody thinks it's for the kids. I would submit to you that I think it's for the parents. And I think that one of the best things we can do is empower our parents to understand the value of an education. I'm a little worried that when our K-12 system became such a norm in this country that we sort of allowed parents to kind of say, okay, I'm going to shuffle the kids off to school now and everything's fine. And I think we lost perspective that the most important thing we can do is make the parents our children's first teachers. And so if parents can engage in that early education and show those children enthusiastically and assist those children in learning and reading to them 20 minutes a day, something as simple as that can go a far way to make that child want to be a great learner. And to me, that's really the importance of our early learning system, is the empowerment of our parents to re-engage in their children's educational process. So, you know, I love this. I am a believer. And again, I think the more we can do to continue the momentum, and even though we are in tough economic times, the recognition is that this is a huge cost saver. Allegedly, $1 spent yields $17 in return, and that's because we don't have as many kids dropping out of school, we don't have to do as much remedial education, and frankly, just keeping our kids interested. This is a tough world we live in, and the kids are inundated with media and lots of stimulus every hour of their lives. And so we need to have a system of education that caters to that, helps them to learn, and keeps them enthused about learning. And I think that getting in there early and tapping into those little synapsing minds is the best thing we can do for our young kids and for our parents.
Thank you, and thank American Edge. I am the freshman, so I obviously will be coming last here and have the most time available. So I'll be taking any questions. But I have spent the last 25 years as a business executive, in the last 15 in the high-tech world. And there's 1,000 good ideas, but it is really difficult. The hardest thing to do is find people to turn those ideas, have the skills to turn those ideas into reality. And what I'm very happy about with this report is it's actually bringing to light the skills gap that we have right now. We live in the most innovative region in the world. We've changed the way people do business. We've changed the way you communicate. We've changed the way you buy 1,000 rolls of toilet paper. And yet our education system hasn't kept up. And one of the things we need to do if we are going to remain competitive in this global marketplace is we have to stop importing workers and exporting jobs. And we have got to start growing and educating and training our own people. And I think, and what this report highlights very much, is that we need to start young. right? We are in a huge budget crisis, but the education is an economic imperative. And if you, and we're, as a business guy, you start looking at where you're getting the greatest return on your money, and it's going to be in the early learning. If we can continue to fund ECAP, which right now we're going to there's talk about cutting it, but that's where we need to focus and where we need to fund, because it will pay out every year forever. Right? It's going to be much more expensive and harder to start trying to change those skill sets in high school and post high school graduation than if we start them young. So I just wanted to thank America's Edge for this report. I want to state my commitment to making sure early education stays funded and that we continue to improve our education system to keep up with this global economy. Thank you.
America's Edge is asking that both state and federal policymakers prioritize and protect funding for this state's and our country's early learning programs, even in these difficult budget times. As has been mentioned, ECAP is under attack right now. There are proposed cuts to it. At the same time, in Washington, congressional leaders are proposing cuts to Head Start and Early Head Start. If you combine those cuts, you will compound the problem of Washington's children having access to high-quality early learning. And as you've heard here today, with a widening skills gap that is just going to get worse, that is simply not good for business.